the river garden.
So I started go.go 4 years ago when I realized there was a need for cervical cancer screening in developing countries. Last spring, there was a good article in the New York Times about how cervical cancer was on the rise in the United States. And I started thinking how maybe we could make a difference. Most of the people who were developing cervical cancer were not being screened. At the same time, there was a new test called an HPV test that had pretty good evidence as a primary screening test instead of pap smears. Started thinking how we could get more women to get an HPV test.
Are you rolling?
I'm rolling.
So when I realized that women could do this test, I decided, I think I was talking to you, and I said it would be great if people could have like a private place to go into. Is my
one and what interests me was the idea of it being accessible to people who normally didn't have either the desire or the will or the means to, you know, take the initiative to test themselves for HPV. A portable place that can be transported easily to bring this to a place where, you know, people have the option to do it, and we're reaching a different sort of population of people that normally don't have these things presented to them. The idea of just reaching for me an audience that someone doesn't either A, expect to see art in that particular place in the public, or whether they understand it as art or not, just that really interests me.
Well, I think your art is bright and colorful and inviting to take something that is kind of scary and that women are afraid to do and so they avoid, and bring it into a fun atmosphere is amazing. Healthcare in general isn't very fun to interact with, so to get the art and the healthcare together to make it more pleasant is
right. Nice. Eat on the ground.
So this is the test. We give women the whole vial, and they're going to take it into the box where they have some privacy, and they're going to take this little brush, lower their pants, and insert it just like you would a tampon. Turn it a few times, and then you open this, put it in, break it off, put the top on. It's that easy. It's not painful. There are no speculums. Nobody has to do it for you. And women testing themselves is just as good as a doctor or nurse practitioner. It's accurate and reliable. After they're done, they give that to us. We send it off to BioReference Laboratory, which has agreed for people who don't have any insurance to give us a reduced rate since we're not for profit. For women who have insurance, we'll take their insurance information and bill their insurance because it's a cover test. And then we contact you in a week or two with the results. A positive test does not mean you have cancer. It does not even mean that you are definitely going to develop cancer. It just means that you have a type of HPV that is associated with cancer. But you do need further testing. We will refer you to clinics that can do the further testing for you if you are positive. This test should only be done for women between the ages of 30 and 65, because under 30, pretty much everybody is considered to be positive. And so once you hit 30, if your body hasn't cleared it, that's when we want to know if you have it. Well, first, if you haven't had any cervical cancer screening in 3 to 5 years, come on by and get tested. If you know people who haven't, send them to get tested. You can also donate, because this is obviously is time and there's resources needed to be able to continue doing this. Donate to go.go, which you can do online. Let us know if you know someplace else that would be happy to have us come and do future art action days.
She's got it covered. All of this wrong, but I'm still right here. I don't have the answers, but the question is clear. Let me ask you.